Convict music.
Once in a while, I'm actually speaking to myself, where it's tired of running. I'm speaking to somebody else. But ultimately, I always had that, you know, it was, that demon was still in me. Like, you still have those voices in you that's, you know, that kind of, that you're battling with, you know? You know, do you feel like you're a sellout now because you don't want to be on the hood no more and hanging out over there? And it's like, you know, everybody's telling you, you know, why you don't come by no more? Why you don't hang out on the, you know, corner with us no more? You're like, bro, I'm a multi-million dollar nigga. I'm not about to be hanging in the corner with you. Like, why would I do that? Like, you just sit there and you're like content with that. Like, I can't be content with a basic ass life. I just don't know how to. Like, as a hustler, you always want to advance bigger than where you were. You always want to make, you know, you want to expand, you know, your success to another level. If I have a dollar today, I want to make sure tomorrow I got two. Like, you always want to be graduating to the next level. And if you around people that's going to keep you at that same level, unfortunately, that's just not an environment you want to be in, you know? It makes me laugh when I hear all these rappers talking about they made $1 million and still live in the hood. Bro, you ain't never struggled then. I'm going to tell you right now, I'll tell you to your face, you ain't never struggled to put yourself back in a struggling environment. It's just not realistic. So I always believe that, for me, it came from the actual experience of knowing what it felt like and not wanting to feel like that again.